So we have now a model that can evaluate a game, the evolution of which we have to enter manually, right? We have to enter here 0, 1, 0 to indicate whether it's a tail or a head. And based on this, what we enter here, the other columns will calculate actually for how long we're really playing. So in fact, these results, when this value becomes zero, these results should be ignored, right? They are generated, but they wouldn't be really coin flips in this game if it ends after five rounds, right? And then the important thing is that the number of flips in my top model, high-level model, is actually linked through a summation function which sums the values here in the last column. And by this, right, because we expect here to have a sequence of values 1, and then from a certain point there will be value 0 to the end of the table. Therefore, if you sum all those values, you will get the number of coin flips that we had in one game. So now what I need to do is I need to shift to the at-risk toolbar, and I need to generate or enter distributions for random parameters. And the random parameters will be values in this column, head or tail. So I'm going to click on distribution, and that will open a window that has all possible distributions in at risk. There's actually quite a lot of possible distributions, most of which I don't even know exactly where they come from. But we will use one of the discrete distributions because we want to generate 0 or 1. This is a discrete random number. And I will just click on the distribution that is called discrete, which allows us to enter any random discrete distribution with given probabilities. So if you click on it, it gives you some default values. The values that will be generated are 0, 1, and 2 with probability 0.3, 0.4, and 0.3 respectively, or 30, 40, and 30%. And right, and you have here a chart that shows you the probabilities of each of the values 0, 1, and 2. Now, of course, I need heads or tails with 50-50 chance. So I will edit this. I will put a distribution 0 or 1, and I will change the probabilities to 0.5 and 0.5. And notice if I did edit them, I get an updated chart that shows me this is the unbiased coin, 50% chance for 0, which indicates tail, and 50% chance for 1, which indicates head, right? So now I can click OK, and you will see that actually there is a function now in this place. Instead of this, there is a function. I'm going to actually delete this risk static, right? It's an optional parameter. This is a function that I could have entered manually, but of course if you use the toolbar, it will help you enter it if you don't know this function by filling out details in a dialog box. So now what I really want is I want to copy this function all the way down, right? Because I want those coin flips to be generated further down. Now, by default, at risk displays an average or expected value of the random variable. Now, right, if I have values 1 or 0 with probability 50-50%, then the average or expected value is 0.5. But the interesting thing is you can, for example, go to settings and you can say that you want to display random values, not static values like expected values. And if you click OK now, you will see one possible evolution of the game. And now this is generated using discrete random distribution, and it is actually a random game. So you see this random game actually took 7 flips, and now we won only $1 after 7 flips, right? And the interesting thing is that I can now refresh in Excel. If you want to refresh, you press F9, and then you obtain another result of the game. So in this example, we have 3 tails at the beginning, and so again we win $5, and we can refresh again and obtain another result. In this case, we had 9 coin flips, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, and then 3 tails, and then the game ends after 9 coin flips, and so in this case we lose $1. So we have now a model that can generate any possible evolution of the game up to 200 something flips of coins maximum. But the problem is now we don't want to generate them manually. We would like some kind of facility that will run this game many times, collect the final payoff from each game, and tell us what is there, what are all the possibilities, somehow represent a large number of possibilities, and this is what we call a simulation. Now, in this case, we have just one scenario. It's this game that we're playing, so number of scenarios is one, right? We will simulate it once, and we will enter here a number of iterations to simulate this. So in the next clip, we will consider simulations and the results of simulations.